Well, in February last year, hugely successful boy band Boyzone were promoting their latest single. But that same week, lead singer Ronan Keating's mother died from breast cancer. For the first time on television, he agreed to talk about his mother's illness.
Ronan, I obviously didn't have the opportunity of ever meeting your mum, so I have no idea what she was like. If you were meeting a complete stranger for the first time and you wanted to describe your mum, what would you say about her? What made her special?
I think the key factor with mum was her warmth to people, you know, and mostly her children more than anything, and her family. She was always so close to her brothers and sisters, you know, and that kind of paid off with us as well, you know. We thought to ourselves, you know, we're going to stick together as a family, like Mam did with hers. And it's wonderful, you know, it's wonderful to have those memories and those feelings of her. She was the most magical woman I've ever met.
How did she and you discover that she had cancer?
She had problems with her breast a year previous to actually her finding out that it was cancer. And I think she was always scared to actually go to the doctor and ask what it was. You know, she was the type of person who thought if she had a headache, she thought she had a brain tumor or something. You know, she was a bit like that, you know. She was a terrible worrier, like I said. So when this started to happen, she got very scared and very emotional about it. And I know my sister Linda and her spent a lot of time together. And finally, I think Linda kind of persuaded her to go to the doctor. But sadly, it was very late when it was found, you know, and it was very large, the tumor. But we did find it, and it was cured and taken away, thank God, and the breast was removed. But sadly, it was so late that I had moved on to the spine, and that's when it really started to all go wrong, you know. But it was a very, very hard and emotional time for the family, and, you know, the key element is basically finding it sooner, you know. And if Mam had found it sooner or gone to the doctor when it first started to happen, we feel she'd still be with us now. And that's why for me and the family, it's all about breast cancer awareness, you know, letting people know that it's okay. It's like you go get checkups like you go to the dentist, you know. There's nothing wrong with that. Everybody, I do it, you know. You have to, in this day and age, the way how rampant cancer is, you know.
Do you wish now, with hindsight, that maybe she discussed it with all of you before and you would have said, Mam, go to the doctor?
Yeah, well, absolutely, totally, you know, that's what we say. And like at home now, my sister and the family we've set up 3 mobile units around Ireland on behalf of Mam, the Marie Keating Cancer Awareness Fund. And they're just basically transit vans that are decked out, and there's a nurse on board, and they go to local supermarkets and shopping precincts or anything, kind of malls around the country. And then people can just go on board and get checked out by the nurse. And basically, it's all about awareness, knowing before it happens, or as soon as it happens, catching it in time to cure it. And if Mam had maybe talked to us or had the guts maybe in the beginning to go to the doctor and face it, and we definitely feel she'd be with us today.
When the Marie Keating Cancer Fund is up and running and helping other women,
please God,
you will want women to think what?
It's a hard question. I guess, I don't know, just that the Mam has helped, you know, that Mam has helped them, you know. That's most important, because she was a wonderful woman, and I always want her name to be immortalized in that. You know, I don't ever want her to be forgotten about. So I guess that, you know, she was crushed by this disease, you know. She really was. She was brokenhearted. She wanted to see her children grow up and her grandchildren. And I guess, you know, she'll take the pain for somebody else so that they can be there for their children and grandchildren.
Do you ever feel bitter about it?
There's no point. It just drags you down. No.
Remember the good things.
Absolutely. You have to.
You mentioned that when your mother was going through all of this, that you were deeply involved in work. You were recording, you
yeah,
were writing, you were on tour.
Mm-hmm.
Are there any songs from that period? I mean, is this a way in which perhaps you've now transferred your feelings and your thoughts and your
yeah.
love of your mother into your music?
Yeah, there's a lot of music that I've written after she passed away that, I don't even know if anybody will ever see it, because it was just a way of me getting it out, you know. There's the B-side of my new single. It's actually a song I wrote for Mam. And, you know, it was something I wrote, and I thought, you know, use it, you know. And again, if it can help, if people listen to it and think, you know, okay, maybe I should pay attention.
This is your song. I wrote it for you. It won't take all day, just a minute or two. You are a friend, walk with you till the end. And one day we'll all sing along, 'cause this is your song.
I'm not putting it on for any commercial reason. It's just something I wanted to do. I just wanted to put it on, and I don't want to emphasize the fact that I wrote it for Mom. I just, it means a lot to me, the song, and it's there, you know. That's as far as it goes, really.
Ronan, thank you very much
indeed. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
That's it for this week.